I want to give another brief explanation of what you're calling your style of music, eye trap.
Yeah, we're branding this genre of music. We're calling it eye trap. What it is it's trap music with an influential message, hence the name eye trap.
Are you noticing any other artists maybe starting to tackle on this style of music as well? Or I guess where did the idea come from?
Well, the idea came from a lack thereof. That's really the main focus of it. I was hearing a lot of trap beats and just wondering, like, man, I wonder what would happen if we just changed the message up just a little bit. Would people still tune in? And then we put that method to the test, and here we are.
Cool.
I'm in this group called the Zoo Crew, and currently I'm doing my own thing. You know, we...
Sure, is it animal-based or animal-themed?
Yeah, definitely. It is. I'm like a lion. I got the dreads. Rawr. He was like a tiger. So that was it.
Do you have anybody else involved in the process overall of what you're doing?
Other than that, I work with a group, a management company, DTM Music.
Okay. So,
yeah, and they're based out of Atlanta.
Atlanta?
Yeah.
So how did you make it down to Atlanta?
It was a long story.
Well, we got time.
We have nothing but time. You're right. It started off with Blue Benjamins hitting the air. Once it hit the air, we got word that, you know, you need to follow the necessary steps if you're going to take this thing seriously. So the necessary step was you need to take it to a major studio. You need to have it mastered properly. You need to have your song coded and taken care of so you can gain royalties and everything. So
you got all the copyright stuff figured out, too.
Everything. It was all... giant learning experience, giant road trip full of good people, good time, good information. But we brought that down there, brought it all back with a final polished product, and the rest is history.
Cool. So of all the studios professionally doing this in the country, Why Atlanta?
Patchworks is just renowned. Like, your favorite rapper's favorite rapper probably is recorded at Patchworks. There's nothing but platinum plaques at Patchworks. We went down there the moment that we got in there. We didn't go directly to Patchworks. We went to Labworks South, which is another studio there, right off, Old National? Yep, right off Old National Highway. Jumped right in there, laid a whole totally new song outside of, you know, what we originally came to do. I walked in, the guy was like, "You ready to record?" In my head, I was like, "No, but I'm here now, so can't turn back now." So we laid two songs, and then the following day, went to Patchworks and had the song mastered and got the giant tour of the studio, saw all the plaques. So yeah, it was definitely a straightforward business trip.
Right on, right on. I've heard a lot of talk about this Blue Benjamin. Do you want to go ahead and explain that?
Well, started off as a song, and we just made it into this giant movement. It's the first single that's going to be on the True Recognize Real album. Again, it's a song about financial independence, financial freedom, what it takes to be there. And we exercised everything said in the song. And then I was inspired by what I heard, and we created Young Visionary. And I asked my friend Ralphie to join along.
Okay, very cool. You want to remind us what Young Visionary is?
Young Visionary, that is the song we just heard, and it is a song pretty much encouraging the listener to keep dreaming despite all adversity.
Very cool. So, new album you said will be called True Recognize Real?
Yeah.
And I guess, do you have a time frame for that yet, then?
We're looking at early December, December 1st.
Sure. Are you planning on maybe doing any sort of extensive tour after the album drops?
That's something that we're working on, actually. And these last four songs, we're also looking to try to get a big name artist on here. I'm trying to get a larger name feature to kind of solidify this album as well.
So I think I heard you guys though were planning on you applied to South by Southwest. Is that correct?
Yeah. Yes. Hoping to get that, man. That would open up so many doors. You have no idea. That would make my entire life if we could just get that.
There is an abundance of people doing music in 2015. What makes you stand out? Rosco P has a whole bunch of different things inside of his press kit that show that, but that's just the process. Once you get in, you have to pay a fee. And once you pay your fee, you go through.
Always a fee.
You always got to pay to play, man. That's what happens when you live here. But yeah, once you pay your fee, you get in, and it's just a waiting process.
By the way, who's on the mic right now?
I'm AG. I'm Rosco's manager.
AG the God.
And I was on the song The Lows, the second verse.
Snapping.
Yeah, that was a good time. But yeah, we've been partners for a little bit.
Yeah.
Just pretty much both co-captains on this success flight.
Yeah.
You know, we got a strong team behind us in Mount Pleasant. That not only in Mount Pleasant, but all over Michigan and Atlanta. So we just trying to make those people proud. Yeah, like I said, a bunch of people are doing music, so we're just showing them that you can actually achieve it, but you gotta pay to play. It's not just a finance thing, but it's taxing on the body.
Yeah.
You don't get to just jump in.
No, you can't just jump in.
No.
Nope.
Cool.